I view the performing arts as not so much what I do, it's who I am. I'm Ben Francis, I'm 15 years old and I attend Scotch College. I live in the Adelaide Hills. I have two brothers, Sam and Christopher. Christopher is 11 and Sam is 8. Oh, mum is a stay-at-home mum. She spends her life running me around until I get my L's and then my P's. She'll be driving. Yep. Dad is an accountant at the Adelaide Hills Council. They're really supportive of what I do. I couldn't ask for better parents, really. I sing, dance and act. Andrew Lobella, love him. Idol.
When he came in for his scholarship interview and he just shone, I think for 15-year-olds, they're still finding their place in the world and they're really trying to work out what is the next step.
Once a week, Mum comes to the school and picks me up and takes me to my vocal lesson. We use the time in the car as kind of a working time, so I'm on my computer. Then I have a 45-minute vocal lesson.
Hi.
Hi, come in.
Then, yeah, Mum takes me back to school. Looking at the 15-year-olds I know, I am probably the busiest. Some nights I get 4 hours sleep. I wake up at 4 a.m. just to do a couple of hours of, you know, homework. So this is my schedule. I do it weekly. So I have this week and next week set up. So I usually have 2 weeks to go on the fridge, and then I print out the ones that I know, and I add the ones that are added.
And Trish, you're obviously across his schedule, or is it you that's helping make the schedule?
Bit of both. I need him to let me know what he's arranged, and then if people ring me and say, is Ben free to do whatever, then I can sort of say, yep, we can probably slot you in there, or yeah, he can do that performance, or
do you sometimes
whatever.
Feel like more of his PA than his mother?
Totally.
Is there time in this schedule for nothing?
Not very much.
Nope.
I'm Kiara and I'm 16. I live in Broken Hill. Broken Hill is like, it's an alright place, I guess. There's like nothing here anymore. Some opportunities and that, but there's not many. I tried KFC and Coles. There's no like spots available that I wanted. I guess the hardest thing in my life would probably be like school, I guess. I fail in that because like I'm hardly at school, I guess. And like sometimes when I'm there, I just don't want to be there all like complete day. Sometimes I get up a bit too late, I guess. Sometimes I like don't even feel like falling, like moving out of bed or anything. So yeah.
So how much school would you miss, you reckon?
A fair bit. Yeah.
Just the teenage years, I think. I'm unsure of it, but yeah, she might have some problems there, or she might be other kids. Who knows?
In our family, there's me, 4 sisters and 1 brother, and 2 also live with my dad. You have to look after the younger ones and that, and yeah. Whenever dad's in town, like, he gets us to do like some of his work stuff and that, and he like pays us for that. Washing his clothes, folding them, hanging them out and putting them back in his bag. Because he's at work, like, 10 days at work and 4 in, I guess. Sometimes when we need the money, he's like never in town to give us it.
It's good to get back out at work, but it's also hard to leave the kids and that behind. So it's sort of, yeah, hard, but I've always been doing it, so they're a bit used to it.
down like the end of Ashtray, like right down the bottom. We turn our Wi-Fi's on, like their neighbours have Wi-Fi with no passwords. So we just sit up and like use theirs. Mostly One Direction stuff. I live here with my auntie, Elaine. And yeah, like I live here like cause it's a lot more quiet and like there's not much going on in that. I guess I moved up there because like sometimes like me and my parents don't get along and my siblings and that. And, like we argue a lot, so I decided to come up here to get away from it. Just all yelling and screaming around and carrying on. I just usually lock myself in the room and just sit there all day and just put my earphones in and just ignore it really.
My name is Mariam, I'm 14, going into 15, and I live in Guildford. I have two older siblings and three younger, so I'm in the middle, obviously. We came here in 2004, when I was four. First, my dad came here on a boat to, I think, obviously sponsor us to come here. Guildford is a place, it's really diverse. It's really colourful, obviously, with the shops and people and the way they dress. It does kind of represent me as a half, but Afghanistan really represents me as a whole. The biggest misconception of Islam is when people think of us as terrorists. This random guy came out of nowhere and was like, "Why are you wearing a scarf? You're a scarfy. You're a terrorist. Get out of this country." Going to school, it's like you're a completely different person to being into a karate. I'm like a really outgoing, outdoor, sportsy type. Learning new skills and techniques just interests me, you know. In karate, there are so many steps you go into getting your black belt. I guess proving to others that, you know, girls are not the weakest. You know, they only think about pink stuff and girly stuff. When really, girls can be outgoing and sporty and, you know, they can be themselves. You really gotta show yourself for people to actually notice you, you know? You gotta stand out from the crowd. And that's really important to me, and obviously from other 15-year-old girls, but I think that's not what's on their minds. On their minds are, oh my gosh, their phone, going out, parties, dresses, and all that sort of stuff. The thing I dream about most is being a clinical nurse, because helping people is, it's in my veins, you know. I think I'm different to an average 15-year-old because, one, my parents are strict. Two, I'm not really allowed to go out a lot. I'm really happy with the way I am right now, and I'm, you know, great that I've got clothes, you know, food, a family, I've got a house, and I'll want nothing more except education.
I want a Ford Ranger. I reckon that'd be good for like when you're travelling and camping and that, so everyone would like look, I guess. And yeah, like asking who owns the car and that and who's driving it. Like, because I'll have a job, car, probably my own family. And like, yeah, and like to look at it like from here to now and that, like, it'd be completely different.
Do you reckon you have a normal life?
I'd say that, yeah. I don't know, some people think I'm not normal because I sleep a lot. And yeah, like, always on like internet, I guess. But I guess a lot of teenagers are like that now, like my age, like heaps of us.
Do you reckon you have a normal life?
I don't, as much as other people in my year, have time for, you know, the social kind of part of life. I don't go to parties very often. I don't hang out with my friends, you know, at lunchtime. In 20 years, I will be living in London and I will be a West End performer.
There is not one of you who cannot rule this kingdom. The slow, the suffering, the quick, the dead.
I think I am the luckiest person. If I was another person, you know, I'd want to have the life I have now. I think it's fun. I love being me. You know, not everyone loves me. Not everyone likes me. But you know what? Everyone has that.